What I hope to do in this video is emphasize the relation, the connection between fractions and division, and then using that knowledge to help us simplify some hairy looking fractions. So let's just do a little bit of a review. So if I say 2 divided by 3, I could write this as 2 over 3, 2 divided by 2 divided by 3. So this expression here, sometimes we might say, hey, this is 2/3, think of it as a fraction, but you could also view this as 2 divided by 3. So if we went the other way around, if someone were to write 4 over, actually let me just do it in a different color. If someone were to say 4 over 9, we could interpret this. This could be interpreted as 4 divided by 9. 4 divided by 9. And in fact, if we wanted to convert this into a decimal, that's exactly what we would do. We would calculate what 4 divided by 9 is. We would divide 9 into 4. 4 divided by 9. So this is all review. So let's just use this knowledge to now think about more complex fractions. So if someone were to say, let me just take this example right over here. If someone were to say 2 over, instead of saying 2 over 3, if they said 2 over, I don't know, let me say 2 over 2/3, well, what would this simplify to? Well, we could go the other way around. This is the same thing as 2 divided by 2/3. So let's write it like that. This is the same thing as 2 divided by 2/3, which is the same thing as dividing by a fraction is the same thing as multiplying by its reciprocal. So this is going to be the same thing as 2 times the reciprocal of 2/3, which is, we swap the denominator and the numerator, 2 times 3/2. So 2 times 3/2, if I have 3/2 twice, well, that's going to be equal to 6/2. And 6/2, you could view that as, well, you know, 2/2 is a whole, so this is going to be 3 wholes. Or you could say 6 divided by 2, well, that's just going to be equal to 3. You could view it either way, and then that is equal to 3. Let's do a few more of these, and let's keep making them a little bit more complicated, just so we get some good practice. And like always, pause the video. You should get excited when you see one of these things, and pause the video, and see if you can do it on your own. All right, let's do something really interesting. Let's say -16/9, I'll do this in a tan color, over, let's say, 3/7. What is this? Can you simplify this complex fraction? Can you simplify this expression over here? Well, once again, we can view this as -16/9/3/7. So this could be rewritten as, and I could write it either as -16/9, or I could rewrite it as -16/9. So I could put the negative in front of the whole fraction like that. Or I could say that it's -16/9, or I could even write this as 16/-9. Those would all be equivalent. But right now I'm writing it as -16/9. And I'm going to now divide. We can interpret this complex fraction as dividing it by 3/7. And so this is going to be equal to -16/9. Actually, let me just rewrite it as -16/9, just to show that we can do it, times the reciprocal of this. So times 7/3. I just swap the numerator and the denominator. Times, do that same brown color. Times 7/3. And now what am I going to get? In the numerator, I have -16 times 7. Let me think about it. 10 times 7 is 70. 6 times 7 is 42. 70 plus 42 is 112. So this part right over here, this part right over here would be -112 over 9 times 3 is 27. And there you have it. You can view this as negative 112 over 27, or you could put the negative out front and you could say, hey, this is the same thing as negative 112 27ths. 112 27ths. And just to make everything come full circle, you could view this as negative 112 divided by 27 or negative 112 27ths, either way.